What's going on, everyone? It's your boy Sideswipe the Boss back at it again with another Arrowverse TV show review, and we have made it to the last part of year four of the Arrowverse, the fourth and final show in year four of the Arrowverse, which is also a new show that has been added, and that, my friends, is Legends of Tomorrow. And we will begin Legends of Tomorrow, of course, at the beginning with Legends Season 1. And once again, as always, if you do enjoy this video, just hit that like button. It takes 2 seconds. And if you do like this video and want to see more videos like it, make sure to hit that subscribe button so you can check out more videos. And the support would be very appreciated. So, Legends Season 1. This is a show that has time travel in it, so that's an interesting aspect that, you know, encompasses around the whole show. But particularly this season, it follows a Time Master, or former Time Master, named Rip Hunter, as he recruits 8 heroes / villains to go around time with him to stop the main villain, Vandal Savage, from taking over the world in the year 2146, I believe that's what it was. When I first watched Season 1 of Legends, I didn't really care for it that much. I mean, maybe it's because the main focus was around the Hawks and Vandal Savage, and y'all know how I feel about them. But now that I look back on it and I've rewatched the season a couple of times, I really think it is better than I thought it was. For standout episodes, there's quite a few of them, including episode 2 entitled Pilot Part 2, episode 4 entitled White Knight, episode 5 entitled Failsafe, episode 6 entitled Star City 2046, episode 7 entitled Marooned, episode 11 entitled The Magnificent 8, episode 13 entitled Leviathan, and episode 15 entitled Destiny, which is basically half of the season, to be honest. And like I said, it's much, much better than I previously thought when I first saw the season. So the main characters list is actually pretty big because it is a team show. We have Rip Hunter, Sarah Lance, Martin Stein, Jefferson Jackson or Jax, Ray Palmer, Carter Hall, Kendra Saunders, Leonard Snart, Mick Rory, Gideon, of a sense, and the main villain of the season, Vandal Savage. There's not really any side characters, of a sense. I mean, there's the Time Masters. They're kind of like side characters. I'm not going to go over them, though. Jonah Hex is in there. I'll go over him. And probably that board man guy who was like the son of Carter and Kendra in another lifetime. I'll go over him too. But yeah, it's mainly just the main characters focus, since it is a team up show and it's a lot of main characters to focus on. So first up, we have Rip Hunter, played by Arthur Darvill. I think that's how you say his name. He is a pretty solid character. I mean, he is kind of bogus for some of the stuff that he did at the beginning of the season. Like when he was like, oh, I picked you guys just because you guys don't really matter to the timeline and stuff. That's kind of bogus. And all the lying stuff, I didn't really understand that much. But you kind of feel for him at the end because he is trying to save his family. And who wouldn't do anything to save their families? I understand where he's coming from. Well, not personally, but I mean, I could understand where he's coming from. But yeah, he's a solid character. He has a really good motivation. Like I said, it's for his family. And yeah, he has some pretty decent fight scenes. I mean, doesn't really got any powers or anything. He's just got a plasma gun or whatever it's called. Yeah, he's a pretty solid character. He has good connections with the rest of the team. And yeah, he is a pretty good leader or captain. Next up, we have Sarah Lance, played by Katie Lotz again. Coming from Arrow, her time on Arrow, just coming back to life. So, I mean, she's struggling with that, you know, the effects of the Lazarus pit on her. So that was a pretty good storyline. And she's a pretty good character in this season. She's kind of like the team, sort of their moral compass, of a sense. Not all the time, because she does have her own agendas sometimes. But other than that, she's a solid character. She has pretty good connections with the rest of the team. She has some pretty good fight scenes as well. Yeah, and she has a good story throughout the whole season. So I give applause to Sarah Lance. Good character. Next up, we have Dr. Martin Stein, played by the talented Victor Garber. And he's a pretty good character. You know, he's one half of Firestorm, so there's that. He has those pretty cool fight scenes, I guess. Even though it's Jax's body they're using. But anyway, yeah, he's a pretty good character. His connection with Jax is awesome. It's like a father to son bond that they grow throughout the course of the show. And it starts out in this season, so that's pretty cool. He has some pretty good emotional scenes. It's funny when they meet his younger self and he's all down talking him as well. It's like, how could I be such a fool like that, or something like that. And it was cool to see. Yeah, Martin Stein is a pretty good character, and he's pretty consistent throughout his time in Legends. Next up, we have the other half of Firestorm, Jefferson Jackson, played by Franz Drame. I think that's how you say his name. And he's also a pretty good character. Like I said, he's the other half of Firestorm, so he has pretty awesome fight scenes. CGI for Firestorm is great. It's amazing, actually. And I really like their suit, but I'll go over that later. But he's a pretty good character. Like I said, he's a part of that father-to-son bond that him and Martin Stein have. And like I said, it starts growing in this season, so that's pretty cool. He has some pretty good emotional scenes, especially when he saw, like, his father. I think it was, like, in the episode where that hunter was trying to kill the Legend's younger selves. And then Jack saw his father just before he died in the war and stuff. So that was pretty cool. And, yeah, it was a pretty good emotional scene as well. He's pretty good when it comes to emotional scenes. But, yeah, he's a pretty great character nonetheless. And, like I said, he's also consistently good in his time on Legends. Next up, we have Ray Palmer, a.k.a. The Atom, played by Brandon Routh, or Routh, however you want to say it. And he's a pretty good character this season. Just like Sarah, he is also coming from Arrow, and in that Arrowverse world, everyone thinks he's dead. Well, mostly everyone thinks he's dead. So it kind of makes sense for him to join the team since he, like, wants to feel useful or something. And it makes sense, and he is useful to the team. He's kind of put on the side just a little bit, not that much, but just a little bit when it comes to, like, being the smartest person in the room, because now that title is for Martin Stein, of course. But he still helps him when he can. He has some pretty awesome fight scenes when he's the Atom, especially that fight scene where he grew big to fight that, like, Leviathan robot. That was an awesome fight. One of the best fights of the season, in my opinion. But yeah, he's a pretty good character. He shows pretty good emotion when needed, and he has pretty good chemistry with most of the characters. The only thing I didn't like about his character is his relationship with Kendra. It didn't make any sense whatsoever. Why'd they even put that in there? They just needed some sort of love interest or love relationship in there. It just didn't make sense to me, and it wasn't very good either, so no on that part. But everything else about Ray was good this season, and he kind of flip-flops from here on out, to be honest. Next up, we have Carter Hall, aka Hawkman, played by Falk Henschel. I know I pronounced that wrong. I'm not even going to try and do it again, but I'm not going to do much on him because he wasn't really in the show, to be honest. I mean, he died in episode 2, and he didn't come back till about episode 13 or 14, one of those two. So, I mean, it's not really much to say. He wasn't that great, to be honest. I didn't like him in the Heroes United crossover, and I still don't like him now. I mean, he is better than Kendra, but that's not saying much because he's not that much better. I mean, he has a pretty decent fight scene or two. But that's really it about Carter. Nothing really special about his character. Next up, we have Kendra Saunders, a.k.a. Hawk Girl, played by Sierra Renee. I think that's how you say it. And just like in Heroes United, I didn't like her character. Yes, she had more to do. Yes, she had more fight scenes. Yes, the story was around her and Carter and Vandal. But it just didn't make her any better. Like, she's just kind of annoying at times. Like I said in the Ray portion, her relationship with Ray didn't make sense at all whatsoever. If you know you're destined for another person, then why are you trying to, you know, have a little affair or, you know, a fling with someone else? I mean, just wait, for crying out loud. I mean, she had some decent fight scenes, I'll give her that. Some of her emotion was over the top, not even gonna lie. That one or two episode storyline where she couldn't control her powers or something, like, where did that come from? I mean, I guess it makes sense because she's new, but once again, like, why? So, yeah, just overall, I didn't really like her character at all. She brought it down a lot, like, a lot more than she should have. Next up, we have Leonard Snart, aka Captain Cold, played by Wentworth Miller. And he was probably my second favorite legend. Well, actually, maybe he was like my first legend of this season, particularly. I know Firestorm is like my overall favorite legend, but particularly season one, Captain Cold is my favorite legend. I mean, he's very funny. He gives off that, you know, nonchalant vibe for most of the season. I like that. He has a pretty good bond with Mick Rory, even when, like, they were arguing. It was, like, and fighting. It was pretty good. It was actually pretty great, to be honest. He has some pretty good fight scenes, pretty good emotion when he shows it, at least. And, I mean, I guess that little, I don't know, what was it, a love thing or, like, one kiss with Sarah? I mean, I guess that makes sense, you know. A criminal and an assassin. I guess that makes sense. A criminal. A criminal and an assassin. I guess that makes sense. But other than that, he's a great, great character. Has some great moments. And his death was pretty emotional because I didn't want to see him die. He was one of the best parts of the show. And I wish he could have, like, stayed. He did come back in season 2, but it was in a different role, but I'll get to that in season 2. Next up, we have Mick Rory, aka Heatwave, played by Dominic Purcell. And he was a pretty solid character. At first, he didn't really fit the team, but I guess that makes sense, just because he didn't even want to be on the team in the first place, and he was just a package deal along with Captain Cold. But he kind of grew on me as the show went along. Pause, though.
Pause, sir.
Over now.
Pause, sir. 10-4.
Him being Kronos was actually a pretty good twist, not even gonna lie. I really wasn't expecting that. So they came out the gate swinging with him, and I like that. But yeah, he has some pretty good fight scenes. He rarely showed emotion, so I can't really count that. But yeah, he's a pretty welcome addition to the team once you really get used to him. And finally, we have the main villain of the season, Vandal Savage, played by Casper Crump. I think that's what his name is. For me, he still wasn't it at all. True, he was a little better in Legends than he was in the crossover, but it's still not saying much. I mean, his motivation kind of didn't make sense. Once again, he's severely underpowered. Like, he should be more powerful than he really is. Especially because in the comics, he's super powerful and super smart and all that. And yeah, he does successfully take over the world, but they still stop him. And he's killable. That's not good at all. He's killable. It doesn't make sense. And also, once again, I don't understand why he has affection for Kendra. But I guess it's 4,000 years brewing. So, I mean, hey, you love who you love. But, yeah, for me, he just really wasn't it. His overall plan just didn't make sense whatsoever. I mean, yes, it was successful. But still, he just wasn't a very good villain to me. So, to quickly go over a few side characters, we got Dr. Boardman, I think that's what his name was. The son to Carter and Kendra in that one episode. He was fine, even though he died the same episode. That Time Master, I think his name was Druce or something like that. He was fine, I guess. Not very interesting. Jonah Hex was introduced into the Arrowverse through Legends. And I actually like the actor who plays him. He's a pretty good Jonah Hex. Way, way better than Nicolas Cage in that one movie.
5 coffins. Thinking you might need 8.
Cut him down!
Connor Hawk or John Douglas Jr., the Green Arrow in that Star City 2046 episode, he was pretty good. I really liked his character, which just encompassed it for the whole episode because that episode was awesome. And there was Marty, I think that's what he wanted to be called, the young Martin Stein. And he was pretty funny, not going to lie. And it was some pretty good interactions with his older self, so that was pretty good nonetheless. Now going over the rest of the aspects, since I spent a million years on the characters, we have the costumes, and I actually really, really like the costumes. You know, the White Canary costume is good, really like that. You got the Hawks, they're fine, I guess. The Adam suit's pretty much the same. I really, really like the Firestorm suit, the red and yellow, or I think it's orange in there too. It's really, they really clash together nicely. Captain Cole, you know, he just has his winter coat, so that's fine. Heatwave doesn't have a suit, so there's that. Vandal Savage has his little getup, like never takes it off unless he's incognito, so there's that. And yeah, those were some pretty good suits nonetheless. The fight scenes of this season overall were pretty average. It's kind of a mix of like how Arrow and Flash do their fight scenes, because Flash does lots of CGI and Arrow does more like hand-to-hand combat, and it was a mixture of both. Sometimes it worked, sometimes it didn't. So overall, they were pretty average fight scenes this season. The side villains of this season, there weren't too many of them, but the ones who did show up, they were okay. I mean, not too many of them had personalities like the Hunters that were coming after the Legends in the back half. They were fine, I guess. But other than that, the side villains were just okay. Nothing really special about them. The overall storyline, it had its ups and downs. It was just the Legends trying to find a way to kill Vandal Savage. And Vandal Savage just wanting to live forever and conquer the world, basically. So it had its ups and downs. It's definitely better than what I first thought about it when I rewatched it, but still not, you know, top tier, not even close to that. But it's just like okay, just a slight okay. Legends didn't really cross over with any other shows this season, although a few characters from other shows did appear in this season of the show, like Oliver did like twice, Laurel did a couple times, or I think once or twice. But it was fine, I guess. None really extravagant, except that Star City 2046 episode where Oliver was awesome. But yeah, other than that, they weren't too extravagant. And before I forget to mention, I did very, very, very much love that cliffhanger for the season where that time ship crashes and Rex Tyler shows up and says he's from the Justice Society of America. That was an awesome twist. I got super, super hyped for season 2 once I saw that. So kudos to Legends for keeping me on the edge of my seat for like 5 months. So overall, Legends had a pretty decent start. I mean, there were a few points that don't really help the show at all, like Kendra, Carter, Vandal, and that storyline with them. So kind of the main storyline kind of makes it drop a bit. But there are some pretty good fight scenes, pretty good cast surrounding those three, and some pretty good emotion when needed. And yeah, it's just a solid start to the show nonetheless. Not great or anything, but just a solid show. If I have to give it a rating out of 10, I'd probably give it like a 7 out of 10. Not bad or anything. Not okay. Just a little bit more than okay, but not great. So I give Legends of Tomorrow Season 1 a 7 out of 10. Well, that's all the time we have for today. Thank you guys for watching this episode. Tune in next time as we are going to start Year 5 of the Arrowverse. And I'm actually pretty excited to start Year 5 because it was kind of a roller coaster, but it had more ups than downs for sure. So be ready for that. Let me know in the comment section down below what you thought about Legends of Tomorrow Season 1. And if you did enjoy this video, just hit that like button and subscribe for more videos. And I will catch you guys next time. Peace out.